is around 4:35, which is sunset on this overcast day where there is no sun to be seen. Although it has rained essentially all night and all day, so you do get that nice highlight effect. So the setting will look a bit different than it usually does. I appreciate this look more than the normal look. There is something of interest to talk about today. I don't know how long it will take. It will probably be short. And that is the benefit of being psychologically distressed. Now, there's a lot of societal stigma that comes along with psychological distress. And there's a lot of consultation out there that operate on the principle that you should try to minimize psychological distress and achieve a more normalized balance in your behavior. However, the thing that people don't talk about very much is the idea that being psychologically distressed could lead to obtaining more expensive knowledge than you otherwise would in a more normal situation. People who are psychologically distressed often see the world in very interesting and unique ways. Ways that a normally functioning person would not think of. The creativity of a psychologically distressed person cannot be matched by a healthy person. And there is a link between creativity and knowledge or understanding. Knowledge is not some boring pursuit which can be distilled down into formalized equations and procedures. procedures that if you follow correctly will always lead to the right answer. Gaining knowledge hinges in large part on your ability to be creative, your ability to see a problem from many angles, your ability to make connections in one area of life and then use those connections to probe other areas of life, ultimately making expansive, overarching, relatable connections. I believe, in a way, speaking of myself, that the creativity that my psychological distress has allowed has, in fact, increased my level of well-being. It is so gray outside. The grayness is very contrastable with the now highlighted darkness of the trees thanks to the rain. I believe that without a level of psychological distress, normal human nature is to seek contentment. I do not believe that true knowledge can be ascertained through a feeling of contentment. And even further, through a feeling of calmness. It is my belief, and my belief alone, that to be content with something is not necessarily a bad thing. But it is of limited usefulness and can be abused if sought too much. Perhaps it's human nature to feel a sense of emotional distress. Perhaps it pushes us to discover things that do not easily reveal themselves to us. Perhaps that is why psychological disorders have persisted through time and have not been selected out through the process of natural selection. Thinking of knowledge in this way as almost only unlockable through the workings of malfunctioning brains is quite interesting. When you think of knowledge, you think of normally functioning brains that are capable of observing the world and making decisions which help them best navigate the world. However, it seems that the most knowledgeable people are the ones who ultimately, through behavioral flaws, tend to make decisions which are not favorable. It is very counterintuitive that the people that suffer from psychological distress tend to be the most knowledgeable in society. This shows the disconnect between being knowledgeable and understanding something and being able to behave in accordance with that knowledge. People like to think that as you gain knowledge, a better society is produced. A society which will act on a higher level of behavior and perhaps morality. However, just looking at society in general, I do not see a link between knowledge or wisdom and a higher sense of morality. And I think that's going to be the end, because it is getting dark and my fingers are cold. So I will leave you with the contrasting view of gray sky and dark woodland. When you turn around 180 degrees, you get a nice shot of the moon. One final thought to go along with a shot of the moon. It's an interesting quirk of human nature, but you can come to understand by looking at the things that society tries to fix. You will often see that the things society deems as undesirable are in fact, in a sense, necessary and desirable. To varying degrees. I think this talk today is very illustrative of that, or very demonstrative of that. And as we stare at the moon, I will say, Happy Thanksgiving.